This is my first one painting a Tesla, actually. The Tesla, what is that, Model X or something like that? I'm a bit tired today, so forgive me if I'm not my bubbly self. But yeah, I still like to wear my respirator when I'm petroling. And it gets up your nose, and I guess probably not much better than paint fumes, really, if you think about it. Originally I would have liked to keep the colour small, but there was a few stone chips in the bonnet that I can't just leave them, so I've got to put colour over sort of most of the bonnet. This is a door handle off another job. Squeeze that in at the same time. And I have a little bit more up the back here. We're actually painting all four wheels on this car here too. And one thing that I've stopped doing recently is originally when I first started using this system, they always used to say, oh, don't use base coat blender on the darker colours because you don't need it. So I just did what they said, and then I found that you get like these little speckles of dust from your overspray when you don't base coat the whole, when you don't base coat blender. So I started using base coat blender recently on all colours, even the blacks and everything. But I got one of these blacks outside and noticed that there was it looks like a contaminated blend, right? And it turns out I did like a few different tests and it was the base coat blender that was doing it. So yeah, I just like treated it like a science experiment. So I actually thought originally that it was like a contaminated rag, you know, let's just say you got some of that primer dust over your blend area. So I spent a bit more time cleaning them out. It was still there. We had to repaint one job because of it. And then I used the base coat blender on one job, but only halfway through the panel just to see. And of course, halfway through the blend panel where I put the blender, you could see it's only very faint, and you don't see it in normal light. Like, you can't see it. Oops. That was meant to happen. Yeah, you could only see it in the sunlight, or when you got your colour check light onto it. You can go up there, you're in the way. Now we're going to get the high pressure air blower, tack rad down. I noticed there was a few bits of dust on the marking today, so I'll get that off. Yeah, the long and the short of it, I'm not going to be using base coat blender on darker colours anymore. But it's annoying because you do get, I guess you could call it profiling. You get these little speckles, like little bits of dust from your overspray. So I might have to start going a little bit heavier with my first coat of clear, but leaving a little bit longer between coats. So hopefully sort of fill up some of those little bits of dust. I've been loving these tack rags too. They're the 3M Aqua tack rags. Awesome. I never even knew they existed until I started here, but this is just what they use, and I reckon they're the best tack rags I've ever used. I can't stand those Gerson ones, man. They're terrible. I just find that because they're nice and big and flat, they get, like they, I don't know, they sort of hug the panel better and you get like a better coverage over the panel. Whereas those Gerson ones, they're just, oh, they're terrible, man. And I saw somebody in the comments on Instagram said, I swear those Gerson ones, like they put dust into my paint job. And I'm like, yeah, I reckon you're probably right. Gonna get that 40 PSI. Man, the guy that's priming this up there, like, why would you use light colored primer on such a dark car? That's gonna need an extra. Because the coverage is not there. Well, you know what? We might get that. I'm gonna have to put that on and then dry it down. Black primer, it's covering straight away. That's annoying. Especially, I wouldn't be usually too worried, but I want to go home. It's uncommon to have to put an extra coat on in standard blue, but sometimes you have to. I like to leave it 5:30 on the dot. I should be right soon. We changed the filters yesterday, but with these boosts, they're blank. Like, they actually drew the suck in. They more just catch it, so every second change will do it a lot. That's how I used to do it anyway. Now you can see where I put that. I had a little bit of a cut through. Everywhere that I put that dark primer, it's covered. Nearly there, nearly there.
Yeah.
We'll see how we go. I'm having a lot of fun fixing it, but I might just have a relaxing night tonight. Corona's not going anywhere. I say that because generally every night I do like 2 hours work on the Corona, so.
Tell you what, it's good to be using this gun again. It's a beast.